In the previous video, we saw some examples of subgroups inside of larger groups, but one has to be very cautious because when we define a subgroup, you take a subset of the group, and then you argue that, oh, it's a group inside of a group, therefore it's a subgroup. Well, you have to be careful because in order to be a subgroup, it's not just that we have a subset which has an operation. It has to be a subset using the same operation as the overset in order for it to be considered a subgroup. So let me provide sort of like a counterexample to what I'm trying to describe here. So consider the groups Z5 and Z6 with respect to modular addition. So if we think of these as sets, Z5 is just the set 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Admittedly, these are congruence classes, but we'll just use the representative 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there's really no loss to just thinking of Z5 as these five elements. Z6, on the other hand, would be the set 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? And so as sets, this is a very natural subset containment here. Z5 contains everything that Z6 has, except it doesn't have the element 5 itself. But the thing to remember here is that although Z5 can be viewed as a subset of Z6, Z5 by no means is a subgroup of Z6. So we would actually say that Z5 is not a subgroup of Z6 here. And what's wrong here? That, well, Z5 is a subset of Z6, and they're both groups with modular addition, right? The problem is, when you talk about modular addition, mod 5, that is not the same binary operation as addition, modular addition, mod 6 there. And so the removal of 5 does not make you go from mod 6 addition to mod 5 addition. And so the idea is sort of like the following. What if I take the elements 1 and 4 in these two sets? Take 1 and 4. Well, when you work with Z6, 1 plus 4 will be congruent to 5 mod 6, and then there's no reduction to do there because we didn't get bigger than 6 yet. On the other hand, if we switch over and do that same calculation with Z5, you're going to get 1 plus 4, which is 5, yes, but 5, our Z5 doesn't actually have a 5 element. It will reduce down to 0 when you do mod 6, or when you do mod 5 right here, excuse me. And the key thing to notice here is that 5 is not congruent to 0 when you work mod 6, but it is when you work mod 5. So these ideas of addition are different operations. It's not the same addition. We might call it modular addition, but the addition is dependent on the modulus itself. And so even though it's a subset with modular addition, these are not considered subgroups because the operation in play is inherently a different binary operation. The restriction of addition mod 6 to the set 0 through 4 does not produce the group Z5 with addition mod 5. Now, in comparison, though, we could consider the following set. Take the set of just 0, 2, and 4 inside of Z6. Now, if we use just these three elements working addition mod 6, we can see that we do, in fact, have a subgroup structure. Notice that 0 is the identity, so the set H needs an identity to be the group. So you take the identity of Z6, which is a 0, 0 plus 2 is 2, 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 4 is 4, we're good there. Then take 2, for example. If you take 2 plus 0, that's a 2, 2 plus 2 is 4, and 2 plus 4 is 0, 0 being 6, congruent to 6 there, right? And so notice that if you operate by 2 with any element from H, you get back an element in H. And then finally, if you have 4, 4 plus 0 is 4, 4 plus 2 is 0, and 4 plus 4 is 2. 8 is congruent to 2 mod 6. And so therefore, if you operate with 4, you always get back something in H, 0, 2, or 4. And so the restriction of addition mod 6 to the set H will give you a binary operation. Operating, adding two elements from H always produces back an element in H. So addition mod 6 does restrict to an operation on H, and therefore H will give us a subgroup. Like I said, it has an operation, right? That operation will be associative because it was already associative in Z6. It has an identity, and we also have inverses. 2 is the inverse of 4, and 4 is the inverse of 2. Another example, what if you take the set 0 and 3? We could do a similar type of thing. 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 3 is 3, and 3 plus 3 is 0. The restriction of addition mod 6 to this set 0,3 gives us a binary operation. It'll be associative because it was already associative in Z6. You have an identity, and 3 is its own inverse. So we have all the group axioms. These are the subgroups of Z6. I mean, of course, you also have the improper subgroup Z6 itself, and you have also the trivial subgroup, just 0. The important thing, though, is Z5 cannot be made into a subgroup. Even if you change the multiplication, or even if you change the operation, even if you don't use addition mod 5 anymore, if you switch to addition mod 6, you cannot get a subgroup structure out of Z5, because basically they have the following problem. You're going to have 4 plus 1, which is equal to 5 mod 6, but 5 is not inside of this set Z5. So we can't make Z5 into a subgroup of Z6. There's some type of restriction there, a topic we'll talk a lot more about in the future.